In this screencast, I'm going to show you some advanced features of MATLAB, particularly related to passing additional arguments to solver functions. Let's start with an example. We have an equation of x and y that's equal to x squared y minus 2x. I have defined the function in MATLAB. I've created a function called fx, a function of x and y, and I've got the equation in there. We're going to plot this between x values of 0 and 1 and y ranging from 0 to 4. I've created a mesh grid here of x and y, and then I've created a z output array that's going to be the function at capital X, capital Y, and then I've created a surface plot. The surface plot is shown here. I can rotate this three-dimensionally. What we're trying to determine here is if I choose a value of Y, so Y is actually is on this axis going into the plane of the screen. If I chose, for example, a Y value of 2, I'm going to be operating on a curve here that is just a parabola in one variable x. And I want to know, if I choose a value of y, what value of x minimizes the resulting function? We want to be able to choose y in the MATLAB command window, and then determine the minimum of the resulting function in a certain bound. MATLAB has a FMinBound function, so we might naturally try to use that. The only problem with FMinBound is your function has to be a function of a single variable. You cannot have a function of multiple variables. So the process we're going to take, the first step, we're going to create a function. And actually, I've already done that. I've created the fx function in a M script. The second step, we're going to redefine a new anonymous function that is in terms of the original function, but only in a single variable. And then the third step, we're going to use fminbound to determine the minimum of the resulting function. And we're going to pass the arguments through the MATLAB command window in order to do all this. So now what I'm going to do is redefine a new anonymous function, f1, that's a function of x, and it is just going to be our f of x function that I've already defined. Remember, f of x is a function of x and y. But now if I'm going to constrain y to be 3.5, I'm going to put 3.5 in here. And now I'm going to do fminbound on that anonymous function between x values of 0 and 1. Now it's very easy for me to go back and change the value of y. I can just change the anonymous function f1 and do fminbound again, and we see that that automatically changes the minimum of the function. So this is how we can pass arguments of a function into functions of functions. For example, fminbound, you can do this to f0, you can do this to the other solving functions, and you're doing it through the MATLAB command window, and you're not going into the actual function and changing the value of y every time. Let's work through another example. I've got a quadratic function, y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, and what I want to do is I want to create a function where the user can input different values of a, b, and c, and calculate the minimum of that function using a function in the MATLAB command window. Right now in our equation above, we actually have four variables that we can change that affect y. We have a, x, b, and c. In order to use the fminbound function, we have to have that function only in terms of one independent variable. And in this case, we're going to make that one independent variable x. The goal is we want to be able to change a, b, and c, which are all going to be constants, in the MATLAB command window. So I've set up an equation here, which I've just named quadratic, and it has arguments a, b, c, and x, and I've got the equation here, ax squared plus bx plus c. So I first defined a, b, and c, so these are just constants that I want to use in my quadratic function. Next, I have defined a new anonymous function. This is only a function of x. It is no longer a function of a, b, and c. Now I can calculate the minimum between the values of 0 and 5 of my new anonymous function f, and I can press enter. And if I wanted to calculate the actual y value or the function value of that at the minimum, I can just do quadratic of a, b, c, and min, and we see that the minimum is negative 12. I've got a complicated example here. We have steam in equilibrium with liquid water. There are two equations that describe this phenomena. The first one is the ideal gas law. So here we have PV equals NRT, where N is just the mass divided by molecular weight. temperature can be in Celsius. We also have an equation that describes vapor-liquid equilibrium, and this is called Antoine's equation. For a given compound, we can look up A, B, and C. Temperature is going to be in Celsius. If we know the mass and volume, we want to be able to find the pressure and temperature. Again, we know these constants. We know R, the molecular weight, A, B, and C. We want to solve for pressure and temperature in MATLAB, but we would also like to be able to pass values of mass and volume in our call in MATLAB to fsolve. So we've got our two basic equations here, and if we rearrange these, we have two functions, F1 and F2. They're both functions of pressure and temperature. They're nonlinear. We can rearrange so they're both equal to zero. When we do this, if we have two equations, two unknowns, then we can use fsolve to solve this system of two nonlinear equations. We're going to use MATLAB to adjust pressure and temperature until both of the above equations are equal to zero. In our example, we have our gas constant, we have molecular weight of water, and then we can look up the values of A, B, and C, the Antoine constants. We have a mass of 3.755 kilograms, and it occupies a space of 3.142 cubic meters. The first thing I've done is I've set up the equations. I have a function here called equations. It's a function of x, mass, and volume. X here represents a vector that contains the pressure and temperature. We have our ideal gas constant, molecular weight. We have A, B, and C. Pressure here is the first component of that x vector. And then the temperature here is going to be the second component of that x vector. We have two equations that both involve our two unknowns, and that is the function that we're going to be passing into fsolve. First thing I've done is I've just defined what mass and volume are. Next, I'm going to define the options. I'm going to turn off the display. Our equations function that we defined is actually an equation of x, but our equations function also depends upon mass and volume. Again, I've declared mass and volume up here. This is similar to the previous examples. So I'm defining now a new anonymous function that's only in terms of a single variable, a vector in this case. I'm going to solve these two equations using fsolve, and I'm referring to my anonymous function here, f, and then I have my initial guess for pressure and temperature, and then I put in my options here so that it's not going to display everything as it's solving, and I press enter. We can say x is this. If I want to format this, I can do format short E, and do X again, and we see that the pressure is going to be around 217,000 pascals at a temperature of around 120 degrees. So this is how you can pass additional arguments through the MATLAB command window into a function, and we never once opened up that function after we had created it to solve it.